Hello everyone, welcome to Silver Star Stables. It is the time of year where we need to pack up autumn and set up for winter. So I'm going to be doing that today and of course bringing you guys along with me because every year and this year for almost every one of the seasons we've decorated and set up differently. So that's what we're going to be doing again today for the beginning of winter. So I'm going to start with packing up all of our little fall pumpkins and our leaves and storing them away. I'm just going to put all the little pumpkins in a bag for next year. I know it's not like technically winter yet, but I always have to set up and decorate a little bit early so that I can make a Christmas winter movie and have that up when it needs to be. So actually, I'm a little late decorating and setting up this year. I'm going to kind of be rushing to get that done. I also, of course, grabbed the pumpkins over at our Schleich house. Did not realize I made so many. Now I just have to collect all the leaves out of the paddock. It's kind of sad putting away autumn. I really love the little pumpkins we made. And lastly, we just need to take down our little corn stalks in front of our house. That is all of autumn. It's really bright out right now. I'm using my shadow so you can see. So it is now actually the next day. We didn't do too much yesterday, but it is actually Thanksgiving Day today. So happy Thanksgiving, everybody. And we're going to continue on with what we started. We have a lot more to do. So I'm going to clear all my Schleich things off this table and it is going to snow. Everything is on my bed now and we have an empty table. No, that was pointless. Sheets of snow. It's like felt, but it's quite a bit different because it's really thin and very fuzzy. I'm pretty sure these are used for under the Christmas tree. And I got this one from Michael's and this one from the Dollar Tree. And I've had these for years and I use them every year for snow under my stable. As you may have seen in some of my previous decorating for winter videos from years before, I have it pretty much just right. And now, of course, we're gonna bring the stable back and I'm gonna set my barn up the same way that I had it because I really like that layout a lot. We have the arena. It's a lot of sections of fencing together. Let's see, oh man. We have the basic stable set back up. Of course, later we'll bring back all the little everyday accessories. These are the boxes with all of our Christmas decorations from last year. This year I didn't have to buy any decorations because I just been saving them from year to year. But of course, I'll tell you where I got most of them. So if you need any, you'll know where to go. So I'm gonna start with just unpacking all of these over at the stable. Right now we're over here at Teresa's house. And of course we will be doing this table as well, but we're gonna do the stable first. So this is pretty much all of our decorations. So some of these things like these candy canes and this sleigh, and of course this bag of Santa Claus costumes and Christmas fairy costumes we made last year. And then most of everything else is from the Dollar Tree and Michael's. Like these presents were from the Dollar Tree and these light up trees. I don't know if they'll have like the same exact things again this year, but I'm sure they'll have like similar things. And then these trees were from Walmart that we got a lot of years ago. These trees we got last year from the Dollar Tree, but we didn't need them. But I think we will need them this year because we're doing Teresa's house. So that's another table to decorate. So we'll need lots of trees. These little miniatures were from Michael's and so were the wreaths and pretty sure the bows were from Walmart. And we also have a whole bunch of lights. Yes, there are lots of them. We're going to put these little, what are they called? They're called Ultra Slim Wire Light Set. Wait, is that really the name? Yes, it is. Anyway, there are these tiny little light set people usually put in like wreaths and things, but we're gonna put them on our Schlage house, this little barn, along all the fences around this barn, just like we do every year. I love it so much. The lights really make it come together. And in this box, I have a bunch of random little things that we will pick through and put up as well. So to get started, I'm going to undecorate last year's Christmas tree, and then I always like to start with placing the trees where I want them. So this is our tree placements. This one here is going to be our main big Christmas tree, and I have a really fun idea for our Christmas tree this year. I hope it works out. And I just put some in the paddocks. I thought it was funny because in the summer, there's no trees here, but as soon as it turns winter, little trees spring up everywhere. Anyway, I also put a couple in the arena. I kind of like, well, maybe that's not a good idea because it's like the arena, but they're in the corners and I think they're very decorative. So I guess we're not going to be using our corners while we ride. Now I'm going to put lights around all the fences. Maybe I should have did that before I placed the trees, but it will be fine. I'm wrapping the lights in the fence now. It's always a bit difficult when you first start because the lights are ridiculously long. And I also gotta be careful that they don't kink. Oh, my darling little trees are now knocked over. Alright, so we have all the lights hung for around the stable. You can't really see them that well, like I can, but like through the camera they look pretty, not very bright I guess, but they will look really good once it's dark and everything. So we have lights around half of the riding arena. They're very pretty, but you just can't see them, like they're not that bright, but anyway, you can really see the lights on the Christmas tree. This is what I was wanting to do this year, is actually put fairy lights or little Christmas lights on the tree. I think it's super cute, and I've hid the battery pack behind it. I kind of do my best to hide the batteries. I have it behind the trees, and for this one around the paddock, it's behind those trees. So I think it looks super good, and this is like my least favorite part of decorating, so I'm glad all the lights are up. For the stable, I thought I was going to put lights on the barn, but then I have decided I'm not going to do that. First reason is because they're really hard to hang on the barn because you have to stick them up somehow. And about the only thing I have to do that is tape, and it doesn't look very nice. And it's really hard to do. So I might, maybe with like a different material, it'd be easier to stick up, but all I have is tape. So I'm not going to put lights on the barn. I'm happy with them on the paddocks and the tree. Now I get to work with all of this fun stuff. I have wreaths and I also have bows. I'm debating on which should go on the fence. We have wreaths and then bows. I don't know. I'm pretty sure I've done both before. So we're deciding on that. We also got these cute little candy canes that of course go on the fence. So I decided to go with bows. We have red and green, red and green. So they're kind of all, they flip back and forth from red and green. But look at how festive it is looking. So beautiful. I love it very much. I also placed the ice pond there. I don't know if that's going to stay there. And it's also getting dark out, so that's why the lighting quality went meh. But I kind of made it long ago. I made it a rule like never to film at night. But since this is kind of like a vlog, I guess, we're going to keep on filming. Even though it's dark out and the lighting is not so good, it's fine because I really need to get this done. And yeah, I really need to get this done. Also, the phone is in the paddock because I was talking to my aunt and putting up bows. So now I'm gonna go feed my animals before it is super dark. And then we're going to come back and we're gonna put something around this paddock. Well, arena fence, just like we did over here. Probably we'll use the wreaths because we're almost out of bows now. So the wreaths are up. I thought they were gonna be really hard to hang because they usually are. But it went very well. It was super easy. So those are up. And now we got a few other things, of course, we have to do. There's smaller wreaths that I gotta hang on the inside of the barn and probably on the front of the barn. And we have these that last year I hung these around the well, under the overhang around the barn. It was super pretty. I think I'm gonna do that again. If you happen to just watch last year's decorating video, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna do that again. I just can't think of anything else that would be better than these. However, I'm certainly going to have fun untangling that. Yeah, lovely. So, I think I will save that and we'll continue with more wreaths. We also have a lovely cup of chocolate mint tea in our very festive mug. I've also kind of just put together a very tiny little Christmas tree with a bow and some pom-poms to put right here beside the big one to kind of conceal the battery pack a little better. I got one fastened on the door. This year I'm using wire and things like that to fasten the wreaths onto the barns and everything, and it is on there really well. That is not even thinking about coming off. Last year I think I used like string and it was very fiddly to put on, and they kind of were moving all over the place, but this is nice and secure. So I got them hung. They're pretty fiddly to put up, so I decided I'm only going to put them on the front. However, I still do have a lot of these little bulbs and they're very pretty, so yeah, like I said, they're all tangled up and I'll probably never have enough patience to untangle them. So I thought I would just fill these, what are they? They're flower containers, but I changed them out for the season. In summer and spring, they have flowers. In autumn, they have pumpkins. So for winter, I thought I could take these off the string and kind of put those in there. Or maybe it's pretty like overflowing. Anyway, I want to use these, so I was thinking about doing that. I've placed one at the front of the paddock and another over here. This one's actually better because they're spilling out, but they're actually not. They're all one big awesome knot. So of course these little presents are super cute, and I especially think so when they're stacked. However, they do not stack very well at all as far as staying stacked. I can just blow a little bit and they all topple over because they're super light foam or whatever they're made out of. Anyway, so I'm gonna hot glue them in a stack so they will stay that way. Also, the desk is a mess. We have many projects right now going on. This is actually very fun to do. I placed the little stacks of packages just kind of randomly around the stable where it needed a little touch of something, like here in front of the wash rack, and I added a few in the paddock. My mom also put these little ice crystals on top of the ice pond. They're really just little plastic sticker embellishments. I'm not even sure where we got them. Hello everyone, it is now the next day and we're gonna kind of pick up on this again. So I was gonna try to do more last night, but I just ended up watching TV and then going to bed. So last night I was thinking about the inside of this barn. It's kind of boring right now. I just have a couple of bows. There's not much going on in here at all as far as decorations. I could maybe like try to put garland up and everything, but I kind of like to keep it very plain in here because I don't really like it to be too busy, because when I'm in here filming and doing things, it's just kind of in the way and really busy. I don't know. So I might just leave it like that, boring, but I might do more. I don't know yet. Second table is a bit of a mess, so we're going to clear this off, everything, and then put down the snow for this table and then set it up nicely. This is pretty much how I had this set up. Unfortunately, this piece of snow isn't quite big enough, but we're just gonna have to make it do. I thought maybe I could put all these little trees here to kind of hide where the snow ends. So we have lights for on this little fence and lights for on this big tree, and I also have all these pom-poms and of course these pots for the arborvitaes that were at the front of the house, and I like to change them out for the season, so I thought maybe I could like stuff them with pom-poms and put candy canes in them. So yeah, that's kind of what I'm trying to do. Make it look cute. I think it looks very like gingerbread house like. Ta-da! So we have the lights on the big tree, and we put a whole bunch of stuffing over here, so it kind of looks like a big pile of snow back here that they like, if they plowed their driveway, they plowed up a big pile of snow. Anyway, it kind of hides that corner of bareness back there, and then the battery pack is hidden behind the tree under the balcony. It's very well hidden, and I put up the little boxes out front as I showed you, and now I'm gonna hang all of these little wreaths on the both of the doors and then all the windows. I have exactly enough, so that is really exciting, and they're all in coordinating color, so it's gonna look really good. They're all kind of like pink shades, so it'll match like the roof and everything. So I believe it is day 3 of decorating. So last we left off is we got the wreaths on the doors and windows of the house. And yesterday my mom went to Grocery Outlet and she saw some little trees and she thought of my stable. So she got us this large light up tree, and it already has the lights on it, and it's a little bigger than the other trees. So it will be the perfect big Christmas tree. And over here, there's these little gold trees that look like they're made out of wire, and they're so pretty and sparkly. I placed one on each end of the barn, and I also added a few presents under this tree. So we're gonna get this one out of the box. Ta-da! I put this large Christmas tree in the pony paddock, and that way I can easily hide the battery pack. I think it's so very pretty, and the golden trees, I put them over here with our little tree grove, I guess, and I think they're so pretty, and I need to find a couple more presents, hopefully, to put under the big tree in the paddock. I also did move these little planters over here to the stable that were in front of the house, just because these are really red and green, and we have a lot of that happening over here all over the place, but over at the house, it seemed to kind of turned out where we have like more gold and actually like pink and things, so they did not really fit in at all, but I think they do over here at the stable. And this doesn't really have anything to do with Schleich, but I also have here in my room a living European cypress, and he's just a tiny little dude, and we've got little fairy lights on him and some little tiny Christmas ornaments, and he's on my nightstand, and it's so very cute. Anyway, I just really like it at night. I can turn on my stable lights and the lights on this little tree, and it's so very charming. The last thing we have to do over here at the house, other than find more presents, is put lights on the pony paddock fence. So this is a 6-foot lights. So this should be perfect to go around the fence. The lights are now on the paddock fence. I just put them on the same way I did for all the other paddocks. And that pretty much wraps up all the decorating. And of course, now we have to bring back all of our accessories because it's been quite inconvenient constantly switching them between my bed and my desk, and they need to come home. Things are beginning to bustle again around the stable, and we cannot forget to get out our Mr. and Mrs. Claus costumes and put them on Charlie and Bella. These little costumes, we made them last year in a DIY video, so if you want to see that, it's still on my channel just a year ago. Anyway, so we have two little costumes, and we also have these lovely, super sparkly, glittery blankets for our Christmas fairies that we also made in a DIY video last year. So these belong to Whisper and Wonder. This is Whisper. I'm going to put Wonder's costume on this little mare, just I guess because I want to, but when we make our movie, it will go on Wonder. So beautiful. This one doesn't really fit her very well because it was made to fit Wonder. And this year we're going to be making more Christmas costumes. So in a later DIY, we're going to make like little elf costumes for our Shetland ponies. Over at the house here, I just brought all the ponies home, and the truck is back, and the horse trailer is out back, the big Christmas tree, and the sleigh, I've just put it off to the side here. I think it needs a new paint job. I think it needs to be painted bright green and red with gold trim. Over here at the stable, we're also all set up. I put blankets on most of the ponies on, well, all the ponies on this side. Over here in the arena, I decided to make it a big paddock today, and we've got the boys out playing, and, well, they don't have their blankets on. They have nice woolly winter coats. But all of our little show mares have their blankets on. I did also make a few special winter blankets for like Charlotte and Toronto last year. So I'll pull those out and put those on them when I have them out over here at the stable. Anyway, I'm so very pleased with our final setup. Alright everyone, thank you so very much for joining me for all this decorating. I am very pleased with how it all turned out, as I just said. And now it is full power ahead on trying to get a movie made. So that is what we will be starting on next. And of course the next episode of The Lee Mare will be made with the stable all beautiful and wintry. So I kind of like the change of seasons in that. Anyway, so that is it for this video. I will see you next time. Bye!